With the focus of the breath. Oh, wait, be right back. Continue to breathe deeply. Starts. Slowly. Relax. Imagine that cascade of relaxation flowing down the body, beginning at the top of the head. Feel the face relax. Just relax. Relax shoulders, arms, and hands. Stomach relax and the low back relax. Breathe in deep. Breathe out slowly. Relax the waist, hips. Feel the thighs and backs of the legs relax. Feel the knees soften. Feel the cascade continue. Relax the calves, ankles, and the feet. Next time you breathe out, release, lower the hands, open the eyes, separate the feet shoulder width apart. Turn the toes in so the outside edges of the feet are parallel. Bend the knees, sink down, tuck the pelvis under, relax even more throughout the body. Gently stretch through the fingers, have your knees out, your pelvis tucked. Feel the same kind of breath in the low abdomen. Same kind of relaxation in the chest. We'll hold a good solid 3 minutes. Maybe even 3.5 since we're right at the end of the unit. As you hold, begin to look for that sense of stillness. Even if your thighs start to tremble a little bit, make, as C.K. Chu says in the book, make small deliberate adjustments and hold with a relaxed stillness. Feel that relaxed stillness in the body. See if you can feel the effect of that relaxed stillness on the mind. also discomfort in the thighs is a good sign. If you find yourself in a bad place holding this, straining or really uncomfortable, just go ahead and come out of it and get back into it. If you have the mindset of pushing through pain, try a different approach of listening to the pain. There may be pain you need to push through, but don't start. About a minute longer. Straighten the legs, lower the hands. Circle the arms up, breathe in. Push the palms down, breathe out. Okay, let's jump right into our review of the last couple moves of the form. Last time we covered withdraw and push, as well as cross hands, feet together. So let's begin from the end of hidden hand punch, and we'll review those two moves together. Three moves together. Get into your good hidden hand punch. If you recall, face the left side of your practice area. Separate feet shoulder width apart. Turn your right toes out 45 degrees. Step the left straight forward and shift forward. Feel 60% of your weight in the front leg. And try to recall, before I tell you, try to recall the arms for hidden hand punch. That's right, it's the right fist vertical. Left hand over the right elbow. So a review of the draw, push, cross hands together. Turn to the left, slip the left hand behind the right elbow. Shift back. Clear the arms. Shift forward, push. Now we're on to the last couple. Shift back, this is cross hands. Turn to the right, bring the left toes in all the way to the front. Shift to the left, step even with the right. Circle the arms right under them. Fold the arms right over them. And step left. And end in the same position you started. Hands relaxed by the sides of your neutral position. Do that a couple more times. Turn to the left hand behind the right elbow, shift back, clear it, shift forward, push. Cross hands, shift back, arms straighten somewhat, turn to the right, turn the left toes into the front. Shift to the left, step even with your right. Circle the arms right on your left. Fold the arms right over your left. Step left to right. Uno mas. Draw and push. Cross hand. Okay, so I'm assuming there's no questions, those moves, but I'll demonstrate them the other way just so you can see the hands again, and nothing else to cover. So, if you, anyone ends up watching this and you have any questions, send me a question. Otherwise, let's practice from the top, the whole thing. I'll say the names. This first time, we'll go through it not smoothly. So what I'm going to do is, we'll say the name of a move. If you're at home and you want to practice saying it to remember it, it'll help you remember, say it out loud as we do the move, and then we'll stop at the end. I'm going to give you a second to try to think of the next move's name and what the next part of the move is, like turn or shift. So this is a chance to work on your sequence a little bit, which is required to really get better. You have to get the sequence down first. So it'll be a little choppy, very choppy. Every move will have too much of a pause, but that's a chance to think of your sequence. After that, we'll go back and do it a little more continuous and it'll feel better. This is for sequence from the top. The entire first section, 21 moves of 108 long, yang. See, that was the pause I was talking about. So get to the end of the move, wait for me, try to think of the next one. Or off right. Or off left. Back and press. Push. Single whip. Hands. Strike the shoulder. White crane spread swings. Knee push one. Playing guitar one. Brush knee push two. Knee push three. Brush knee push four. Sorry, I didn't give you much time on that one. I'll be more patient on this next move. Get to the end of the move. Try to think of what comes next. say it, or even say it out loud for me. Playing guitar too. Brush knee push 5. Hidden hand punch. Withdraw and push. Cross hands. Feet together. Okay, cool. So let's go, you know, how to practice as a beginner. How to practice. First, there's memorization. You know, I taught Tai Chi before the COVID thing. I taught Tai Chi to a couple pay classes at like nursing homes or assisted living, I guess that's what we call them these days. I started these classes with the intent to teach Tai Chi, but all of the classes evolved into Qigong, where we would do the same postures every class and just work on that. Because memorization is the main challenge to get over when you're learning Tai Chi. So some people memorize easily, some people don't. If you have trouble with memorization, stick with it. Once you get it memorized, it will open up into a whole different thing. If you are really good at memorization, you have a different challenge, which is you might memorize the moves and think you know Tai Chi. So I like to think of it as like a high school diploma or something. It's like once you've got to this point, now you can really start learning. So maybe that's not the most encouraging thing to hear when you're trying to learn these, but you will, if you stick with it, you will memorize it, and then you'll be able to start relaxing into it. So why am I saying all this? As we go through this form this next time, start to look for just a general sense of relaxation in the bodies. It'll be harder to do on the moves where you don't know as well, because you'll be thinking about it and it'll tense you up and you just can't think about relaxing while you're thinking about other stuff. But when you think about it, when it occurs to you, see if you can relax through the whole body, almost like we were doing that breathing exercise, right? So as you're moving, feel like, oh, I can relax. Okay, so we'll go through it, like I said, a little more smoothly without the really, we'll still stop it like we do when we're learning, right? But it won't be the waiting for you to think of it. I'll still say the names if you want to say them back, that's on you. So begin, relax, put yourself back in the mind of the warm-up meditation. Set left. Commencement. Four off right. Four off left. right grace for us, please. Brush and push forth. Play guitar one. Brush and push two. Brush and push three. Brush and push four. Playing guitar two. Brush and push five. Hidden punch. Withdraw, push. Cross hand. So, let's go ahead and dial out our basic training. Follow the five hearts: faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility.